Hello dear friends, welcome to our YouTube classes. In today's class we are going to learn about a grammar part. It's very useful for the SSLC examination point of view and for all the grammar lovers. And let's start today's topic, that is finite verbs, non-finite verbs and infinitives. What are finite and non-finite verbs? How they are identified in a sentence? Let us look into the topic in detail. Let's look at the finite verbs. What are finite verbs then? A finite verb which shows time, or a verb which is limited by number, person, gender of the subject is known as a finite verb. Let's look at the example. Ravi sings songs. Here Ravi is a subject, sings is the verb and songs is the object. And they sing songs. We sang songs. Dear friends, look at the verbs, how they are used in different ways. In first example, Ravi sings is there. Second one, sing is there. And in third example, sang is there. Here, Ravi is a third person singular. Therefore, the verb takes yes there. And in a second sentence, they is the plural. Based on that, the verb is in its original form, sing. And in the third sentence, we sang. Here the tense of the sentence is simple past tense. Okay, in the above examples, the verbs sing, sings, sang are the finite verbs, because since they indicate tense, whether it is present or past tense, therefore a finite verb carries tense on its own. Okay, and a very important note to be remembered. What is that? All the be forms, do forms and have forms, and also the modal auxiliaries are considered as finite verbs. Why? Because they change when the tense is changed. Okay, look at the examples. Vinay is writing all the time. Here Vinay is writing, is the auxiliary verb, or we can say helping verb, writing all the time. When a tense of this sentence is changed, what happens here? The helping verb changes. Suppose it is in present continuous. If you change that into past continuous tense, what happens? Vinay was writing all the time. Here only the helping verb changes. So therefore, that helping verb is considered as finite verb. And the next main verb is unchanged. Therefore, it is non-finite verb we can call. And Vinay has written me a letter. Here the same thing. Vinay has written me a letter. If you change the sentence of this tense of this sentence, automatically the helping verb has changes. And I do not know her name. If you change the tense, I did not know her name. And I could not believe that he could bring chocolates for me. Here is, has, do, could, can, will, shall. These are all the helping verbs, the be forms, do forms, have forms. They change according to the tenses. Therefore, they are considered as finite verbs. Then let's look at the non-finite verbs. A verb that does not show time, or a verb which is not limited by number, person and tense of the subject is known as non-finite verb. As I said in the previous examples. Look at the examples then. They were waiting for the bus. Here, they were waiting for the bus. Again, this is in past continuous tense. Suppose if you change the tense of this sentence, here the helping verb changes. The main verb, it remains unchanged. It remains the same. Therefore, it is considered as non-finite verb. He has written many novels. Ramesh tries to write stories. Okay, these are all. And look at, again, based on their different functions, again, the non-finite verbs are subdivided into, are classified into three main categories. They are infinitives, gerund, and participle. Let us see in detail what are infinitives, what is gerund, and what is participle. And look at infinitives. First of all, let us learn how these infinitives are formed. It's formed by placing to before the root verb. Okay. Look at the examples. How they are used along with their sentences. As direct objects. Infinitives are used as direct objects. Example, I like to write in English. Here, it is used as a direct object. See, one more thing. Write is the main verb. And to, the preposition is placed before the main verb. It indicates the infinitive. Okay. And it is also used as subject complement of the sentence. His ambition is to fly or to indicate the purpose of an action. He bought some flowers to give his wife. Okay. As an adverb, we can use it. I can't wait to see. And it's also used as an adjective. It's wonderful to have close friends. And it's also used as the subject of the sentence. To swim in that sea may be dangerous. And used with question word. Tell me when to press the button. And after a noun or a pronoun object referring to a person. I invited a friend to attend the ceremony. Here, to write, to fly, to give, to see, to have, to swim, to press, to attend. All these verbs. There is a main verb and before that there is a to. It indicates that these are called as infinitives. Okay. In a simple way, I'm trying to convey. And let's look at the gerund and participle. As we are already well aware of the gerund and participle, then what is gerund? A gerund is a word ending with ing and has the force of a noun and verb. Therefore, it is also known as verbal noun. Okay, and it is formed by adding ing to the root verb. Look at the example. Reading increases our knowledge. Here, reading is considered as a noun and it is here called as gerund. Okay. Reading the story, he sat in the chair. Here, reading the story. Here it is used as a participle. Walking is a good exercise for health. Again, here it is gerund. It indicates it is considered as the noun. Okay. And she hates worrying about the future. She hates worrying about the future. Here it's considered as a gerund. Then, having completed my degree, I applied for a job. Here it is participle. Technically speaking, the computer is a great invention of modern science. Here, technically speaking, it is considered as participle. Okay. Here, reading used as gerund. Here, the next sentence, reading is considered or used as participle. And walking in the third sentence is considered as a gerund. This is how the gerunds and participles, they differ in their uses. Okay. I hope that I tried my level best to reach you through this small video about the finite verbs, non-finites, gerunds, infinitives and participle. Okay. If you like the video, please share with your friends. Till then, take care. Thank you. Bye.